Hello and welcome to Maths Table. In this lesson of Algebra, section 1.7, we are going to discuss how to solve quadratic equations using quadratic formula and how to determine the nature of roots using the discriminant. Now, first of all, let's discuss the general form of the quadratic equation, which can be written as ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, in which the three constants a, b, and c are unique for any particular quadratic equation. And what we discussed in the previous sections was that how to solve such a kind of equation by using either the sum product method or factorization method, and also by using the completing the square method. But what if we apply the completing the square method on this general formula directly using the same alphabets A, B, and C? So by doing that, we'll obtain the final completing square form, which is x equal to minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac over 2a. Now, this computed square form of the general form of the equation is simply known as the quadratic formula. And it's a very simple way to solve any quadratic equation just by identifying the values of a, b, and c in that particular equation and by substituting them into this formula. Such as, for example, in this equation, 2x squared plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0, we can easily see that the value of a, which is the coefficient of x squared, is in this case 2, the value of b is in this case 3, and the constant term c is minus 2. So what we'll do is, we'll simply substitute these values of a, b, and c into this quadratic formula, and hence we'll obtain this expression, which we can easily solve either by using a calculator or we can solve it manually. So in this way, we get the two solutions of this equation, which are x equal to 1 over 2 or x equal to minus 2. So this is how we can easily solve any quadratic equation by simply putting the values of the three constant a, b, c into the quadratic formula. Now, this one important thing to note here is that the expression which is written under the square root sign b square minus 4ac is known as the discriminant of the formula, and it tells us the nature of roots or the type of solutions which we can obtain by solving any particular quadratic equation, such as we may obtain two different solutions, or we may obtain one solution, or we may not obtain any solution for a particular equation. So we're going to discuss this discriminant in much detail in the following section. Now, how to determine the nature of roots? What we'll do is, this expression b square minus 4ac, which is the discriminant, can be used to find out the nature of roots and the number of solutions. Now, how this can be done? We'll simply put the values of a, b, and c into this expression rather than the whole quadratic formula. So by doing that, if we obtain the final value of b square minus 4ac greater than 0 or positive, then this means that this equation will have real and distinct or two different solutions, just like we have discussed in the previous example. And also, if this is the case, then if we draw the graph of such kind of an equation, it will cut the x-axis at two different points. We may get a graph with a minimum value but no maximum value, or we can also get a graph of a maximum value but no minimum value. The shape of the graph is determined by the values of a in the equation. If the value of a is positive, then we'll have a minimum point, and if the value of a is negative, then we'll have a maximum point. We'll discuss about these three constants a, b, and c in greater detail when we'll focus on the graphs. So in case 2, if this value b square minus 4ac becomes equal to 0, then the equation will have real and equal roots. Now, in this case, the square root will become 0 and the final answer will simply be minus b over 2a. And if we draw the graph of such kind of equation, it will cut the x-axis at one single point. Or we can also say that the x-axis is a tangent to the curve. Tangent means that it cuts at one point. But what if the value of b square minus 4ac is negative or less than 0? In that case, the square root sign will become negative and we won't be able to calculate any value of the solution as the square root of negative number is undefined. So we'll get no real roots or complex roots, or if we draw the graph of such an equation, it will never cut the x-axis. So what if we combine the first two cases together, which both contain real roots? In that case, we'll get another case number 4, which is BISE 4C greater or equal to 0, in which we'll simply call real roots. So this is how we can use the discriminant to determine what will be the type of the graph of the equation, or how many number of solutions or number of roots or the nature of roots we can obtain. Now let's take an example. Here we need to solve a quadratic equation xk plus 5x plus 18 equal to 0 using the quadratic formula. And also we need to find the set of values of a constant k for which this line y is equal to kx plus 2 is a tangent to the curve y is equal to xk plus 5x plus 18. So first of all, we'll check the quadratic equation. Just like we discussed before, we need to first identify the values of the three constants a, b, and c, which in this case are a is equal to 1, b is equal to 5, and c is equal to 18. Now in the second step, we'll simply substitute these values into the quadratic formula and we'll try to solve for the values of x. But once we substituted them, we check that this square root is negative in this case, which clearly goes to case number 3, in which the expression b square minus 4ac was less than 0. So as we cannot solve this negative square root, we won't be able to get any solution, or we'll obtain no real roots for this quadratic equation. Now in the second part, what we need to do is, when this line is going to meet this curve, at that point, it will be a common point which will lie on both the curve and the straight line. And since this is the same point, we can simply equate their y coordinates to each other. Now, rearranging this equation by shifting the terms on the right side on the left hand side, we get a simplified version xk plus 5 minus k times x plus 16 equal to 0. Now, again determining the values of a, b, and c for this quadratic equation, we get a is equal to 1, b is equal to 5 minus k, and c is equal to 16. Now, what we'll do is, we're going to use the discriminant in this case. Now, if we want this line to become the tangent to this curve, we know that we need to apply case number 2 here, which is b square minus 4ac equal to 0. So we'll deliberately apply this case here, and we're going to substitute the values of a, b, and c into this expression, and by simplifying this equation, we'll get another quadratic equation in terms of the constant k. So by solving this equation using a simple sum product method, we finally get two values of k, which are k is equal to minus 3 and 13. So if we use this value of k, minus 3, by substituting it into this equation, this line becomes y is equal to minus 3x plus 2. And if we draw the graph of this line, y is equal to minus 3x plus 2, and this curve on the same grid, we'll see that this line will become the tangent to that curve, or this line will meet this curve at one single point. And the same goes for the second value, 13. If we substitute it here, this line becomes y is equal to 13x plus 2, and if we draw the graph of this second line and the curve on the same grid, we'll again obtain a single point of intersection between this line and the curve. So in the end, we would like to thank you very much for your valuable time in watching this video. We hope this video was very helpful for you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates. And please don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Facebook to contact us directly. Thank you very much and have a nice day.